One of our more popular friends, Marty Smith, is in with us, and he's got a new book, Never Settle, Sports, Family, and the American Soul. It will be available tomorrow. I did not know that you were a writer. I did not know that you enjoyed writing.
Much like you, I studied print journalism. I was a sports writer for many years before I fell into television and all that. So I love the written word. I think it's wonderful, and I appreciate my publisher giving me the opportunity to tell some of these stories that I've been able to go all over the globe and produce, some of them for ESPN, some of them not. I discuss my wife and my children and my grandfather, who was in Patton's Third Army, et cetera, and I discuss you guys. I wrote a whole chapter about you fine folks, and I will tell you why.
Wait a minute. A whole chapter?
An entire chapter. I think it's an entire three pages.
We get a whole chapter of three pages.
Still not going to read it, so you have to tell me about it.
Maybe we should do this as just Marty Smith.
Actually, wait
a minute. Mike, because you like Marty Smith's voice and because he just makes you happy and because he's very good at television and radio, why don't we just do Marty Smith self-involved narcissism about our show? Audio book for the audience that might not necessarily want it, but is going to get it anyway.
You're going to get it anyway. That's right. It's chapter three. We're not going to do that. When college football fans give me grief for spending extensive time in towns other than their own, and they do that often, I have a standard explanation. I go where they're good. They're damn good in Clemson, South Carolina, home of the Tigers and steeped in tradition. And since 2015, I've spent as much time in Clemson as anywhere on earth. I joke often, I need an apartment there. Because I need an apartment there. After the Tigers won the 2016 national championship, President Donald Trump invited Clemson head coach Dabo Sweeney and the boys to the White House to celebrate and be acknowledged for the accomplishment, as many championship teams customarily do. ESPN, in turn, sent my team and me to Washington, D.C. to cover this landmark day. It was a landmark day for us, too, for very different reasons. It was a Monday, and it was hot enough to make the devil sigh. Before Clemson arrived, I was on site at the White House previewing the Tigers' visit on various ESPN platforms. One of those programs was, ding, the Dan LeBatard Show, an irreverent ESPN radio extravaganza. The show is simulcast on television live from the Clevelander Hotel in South Beach and features hosts Dan LeBatard and John Wiener, did y'all even know Stugatz' last name, whom the world knows as Stugatz. Stugatz, which Dan tells me is an Italian word that translates into English as bull testicles or something like that. I adore both men, the main reason being that their give-a-dams are broke. They never take themselves too seriously. That reminds listeners that it's okay to laugh and it's important to wonder aloud about things that inspire wonder. Their show inspires me to think and be unafraid to create and be weird. Most of us are weird. Own your weird. Publicly, they have very distinct personalities. Dan is a classic skeptic, unafraid to ask any question of anyone. Stu plays the village idiot, who is, in fact, smarter than you are. Together, they're brilliant. Together, they beat the system.
I don't know about this.
Hold on, man.
I don't know about this book.
My audio book is just ruined now. Together, they're brilliant. Together, they beat the system. They built a sports radio empire by mocking traditional sports radio. ESPN is very fortunate to have them. They are the antithesis of the standard ESPN model. Away from the mayhem, both are caring people who open their hearts to friends. I once saw Dan in a telling moment of compassion toward his father. I was a guest host on Dan's daily television program, Highly Questionable, which features his father, Poppy, as a co-host. That's the dream, right? Get paid to hang out with your old man and talk ball? We were sitting on a desk set, taping the program, and Poppy was to read some jokes off a teleprompter. He got a bit frustrated trying to read one particular line. He tried several times and grew more frustrated each time. Dan took him by the hand and said, "Sweetly, Poppy, it's okay. Take as much time as you need. We're not in a hurry. You'll get it." It was quite a moment. Don't go thinking it was cheesy or some sort of put-on either. It was genuinely sweet. And Dan might junk punch me for telling it because that moment was the polar opposite of his brand. I'd never seen Dan in loving son mode. My respect for him professionally was already lofty, but just then, that respect transitioned from professional to personal. I miss my daddy terribly, so to see a man appreciate and respect and care for his own father moved me. On the LeBatard Show set, a glass partition separates the studio from the control room, in which a group of young producers named Billy and Roy and Chris and Mike hang out. They all play pivotal roles. Other than Mike, I'm not sure what the hell any of them do, but their collective sense of humor is infectious. Another producer, Allison, is the show's conductor, charged with keeping this South Beach yard sale on the rails. I'm going to fast forward because we have like 50 seconds. Uh-huh. Here's the deal.
You love us.
I'm doing this report. I'm doing this live shot with these guys on this place, Pebble Beach, where all the national reporters do their live shots. And you can see the White House in the background. And you fine folks said, Marty, send somebody out for a pass.
That's right.
So I send my audio man, Corey Harrelchak, a former a minor league baseball player, out for a post pattern on the White House lawn. 30 yards, boom, I hit him right in the chest. I think we've won the lottery. Some guy peeks his head around the corner and goes, if you do that again, you're going to get shot. Meanwhile, all of these guys are like, do it again, do it again, do it again, do it again. Thank God the Secret Service has a sense of humor. I love you guys.
Weekend observations next.